You know, BP put a lot of thought into what would happen if there was an oil leak in the Gulf. Not really. But some folks at St. Mary's did in Edwardsville. Yeah, that's right. Michael Lowrum is the team mentor here, and Sean Simlin, one of the students, joining me. And tell me about this project that started way before this whole Gulf spill happened.
It's part of Bob Ball. It's a educational robotics program that's put on. They come up with a scenario, and the kids have to figure out how to solve it. They build two robots out of... Each school gets an identical kit that all the teams build their version of a robot to try to solve the problem.
Now, what was the problem you were trying to solve?
Well, you get different points for different objectives. And so what we try to get is all the points on our side. It's another half of the board.
Gotcha.
But we couldn't get everything. But this is, we're going to show you what we get. We go for Bacchae first. He's our main part of our game. We put on the green line and get the clean ducks.
So the guy, but y'all were thinking of an oil spill scenario when you came up with this project. You were trying to find the oily frogs and the oily ducks, right?
Yeah, and we put the oily ducks into the clean duck center, and that's what this would be. That's what they get cleaned.
So ahead of the game. Okay, show us how this works.
The robots are started by the light.
Gotcha.
First thing it's going to do is try to grab Bot Guy, which he just did.
Look at that.
This is all autonomous. There's no remote control at all.
It's going on its own.
On its own. The kids programmed everything.
Gov has nothing to do with it. Look at that.
So if BP can't get it together, I think we'll go down there and...
Yeah, I think y'all could.
We could build some robots to go solve the problem.
What did you think after you had this as your project, and then you see this happening in the Gulf, you're like,
well,
that's kind of
ironic. Well, first thing I thought was, I hope they don't come up with some nuclear scenario next week or... Next time.
Yeah.
You know, they don't need to come up with a worse disaster than what we already have.
Oh, boy. It got messed up over here.
It got messed up right here. It's gun shy again.
Of course. Well, it's a robot. It's a robot. That's what
These
they do.
These aren't really a competition field, so it's a little bit different size.
Yeah, you've had to kind of try to fix it for our lobby, which is not really a standard field of play for you guys. We kind of put you out of your
element. Just to give you an idea, they ran... 20 some odd times without any flaws.
20 times. That's awesome. Congratulations. So what did they give you for your prize? Did you?
A good job. We got some trophies.
Got some trophies. Here they are right here. There's the hardware they earned at the International Bot Ball Tournament.
First place in double elimination. That's when you go against other teams.
Gotcha.
And second overall and 100% on the documentation.
Have you been hearing from BP yet? Have they asked for your help on
this?
Not yet.
I think they're afraid of us.
I think they are, too.
Yeah.
I think you're probably right. They need all the help they can get.
It looks like we've rescued four ducks. We'll hope we can get them into the oil duck center here now.
To get them cleaned up.
Get them cleaned up.
Yeah. And then they're up.
Yep.
These are clean ducks. They're going to put them on the line, and they're being observed by Bot Guy, and he's going to make sure that they're released in the wild properly.
Look at that. These guys have figured it out right in Edwardsville. You hear this, BP? Give them a call. Stick around. We got